decision. The judges for this bout are Calvin Caldwell, Brian Pacillo, and Robert Madrigal. And the referee in charge is Master Winston Matthews. Introducing first, fighting out of the Grand Victoria Casino, Elgin Blue Corner. He stands in at 5 feet 9 inches tall. Official weight, 155 pounds. Professional record includes one win against two defeats. Representing Team No Comment. And joining us from San Luis Potosí, Mexico, by way of Chicago, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Guillermo El Gallo Negro Sermens. And his adversary across the cage to my left, fighting out of the Mio Fight Gear Red Corner. He stands in at 5 feet 10 inches tall, official weight 155 pounds. Professional record outstanding as he has one win against no defeats. Representing Midwest Training Center and hailing from Chicago, Illinois, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ill Will.
All right, Ray, we'll see if this one lasts any longer.
certainly we'll find out. 30 seconds is very quick, but Ill Will Brooks, Guillermo Sermens, this one should be a barn burner. A lightweight matchup between two outstanding fighters. Both guys have an extensive amateur career. And look at that. And Guillermo Sermens throws a left hand that lands. Guillermo goes down now as Will Brooks trying to press the action. Wants to stand and bang. Also some nice knees in the clinch by Ill Will Brooks. Bad intentions behind those knees. And he just throws down Guillermo.
And that's exactly what Brooks said he wanted to do. He really wanted to stand and bang. And if it has to go to the ground, he'll take it. But he really would prefer to stand up.
Guillermo Sermens with a record of 1-2. Nice knee as Ill Will Brooks won in middle of January. He defeated J.R. Hines. And one thing about Ill Will Brooks is he's 24 years of age. He's in great physical shape. Only one of his fights have gone to the decision. 7-0 as an amateur. He had 6 wins by way of stoppage, and he stopped J.R. Hines in the first round. He's been training under the tutelage of Alex Trujillo and Joe Smith for 4 years at Midwest Training Center, so he has a long background of preparing for this moment, as both Ill Will Brooks, Guillermo Sermens, wearing the black and gray is Brooks, wearing the all black is Sermens.
And Sermens is coming off of a loss in September of last year to Christopher Garcia. He was submitted by rear naked choke in just the first round, so he really has a lot to prove. His other two fights have actually been by split decision.
You know, one thing about it, Lisa, Guillermo Sermens, he actually fought internationally. He fought down in San Jose, Costa Rica in an international 8-man lightweight tournament, so he knows what it's like to fight under the bright lights and under pressure. Will Brooks and Guillermo Sermens electing to stand and trade in the early going. Great crowd on hand here, Lisa. Sold out Odeum Expo Center here in Villa Park.
It is. It's terrific. You could see, you could just feel the excitement in the air, and everybody's having such a wonderful job. I mean, look, we're seeing, you know, first fight, 30 seconds. This one obviously taking a little bit longer. But I do want to mention, too, that Sermens' brother is Ricardo Sermens, who's a former ASU wrestler, and he's really helped him a lot with this fight.
A kick to the groin as Sermens taking some time to gather his thoughts, and that certainly hurts you in more ways than one, as Sermens going to take a little bit of time. You look at the face of Sermens, his nose is red from those jabs and the punching ability of Ill Will Brooks. Brooks is looking a lot more fluid on his feet, and every time we see him fight, Lisa, he gets better and better. He's so fluid. A nice leg kick by Sermens, and Sermens wants to go ahead, but retaliating back and answering back is Will Brooks.
And see, Brooks knew coming into this fight that Guillermo's a southpaw, so he said he definitely trained for that in particular.
Ill Will Brooks, Guillermo Sermens. Sermens very crafty, likes to go ahead and gets underneath, now looking to take down Will Brooks. That is not happening. Brooks kind of tosses him away, and now a nice left hand that lands for Will Brooks. Sermens going for a takedown, but Brooks is so strong, and outstanding technique by the 24-year-old.
Yeah, he's really doing a phenomenal job. You just saw that leg kick right there. You know, as I said, he really wants to stand up and bang, and a takedown right there, though, to Sermens.
And nice job by Will Brooks to get a takedown, and Sermens looks to be gassing out. The conditioning of Will Brooks is not in question whatsoever. He's in outstanding physical shape, but Guillermo Cermet seems to be fading, Lisa.
He is, and you know what? It's sad to see that in the first round with all the excitement that's generated for this particular fight, but, you know, he's really got to try to start holding his own.
What a capacity crowd here at the Odeon Expo Center in Villa Park. But now Cermet gets a takedown, but getting out of it and spinning around is Will Brooks.
And Will Brooks spins around. He's just quick. He's quick on his feet.
Brooks spins around and gets the back of Guillermo Cermet. Now he's trying to lock in the hooks, but Cermet's not allowing him to do so.
But it also doesn't seem like Cermet has a lot of energy on the ground right now.
Will Brooks right now looking to take the fight to Guillermo Cermet. Lisa, right now Guillermo Cermet looks very tired, and those punches of Will Brooks are taking an effect on him.
He's having a heck of a time trying to get out of this position right now. I don't think he has the energy to actually try to flip him off.
He has to buck. He has to make some movement a little bit. He's basically in a defensive position. Is Guillermo Cermet, as Will Brooks trying to soften up Guillermo Cermet. You can hear the corner of Guillermo Cermet tell him, get out via the back. But right now, Cermet is just, he's being stretched out.
20 seconds
to go in our opening round. As Will Brooks trying to lock in the hooks, but he's just happy right now, peppering the side of the head of Guillermo Cermet.
Nice elbow by Brooks.
Will Brooks in total command of this first round here at the Odeon Expo Center, and the hooks are in now. The right arm underneath. Can Guillermo Cermet hold on, or will he succumb to the rear naked choke? It is deep. How deep is it? Cermet has just left his neck out there. 10 seconds to go. He kind of gave the thumbs up as to say he's okay. He's stretching him out, but he lets it go, does Will Brooks.
I'm surprised. It really doesn't even look like he was trying to fight that at all.
And that is the end of round one. It is in the books. What a round, as Will Brooks looked impressive.
Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank our great sponsors here tonight at Chicago Cage Fighting Championships. Antipasto, join us at Antipasto for the official after party. Pabst Beer, Mr. Charity, the Grand Victoria Casino Elgin, ABC, Tattoo Candy, Leverage Bike Gear, and 505 Video Games. Also, Mr. Charity Foundation is providing a positive and a brighter future for all of our children and communities. They are proud to be here tonight with the support of the Chicago Cage Fighting Championships and thepartytrailer.com. Please stop by the Party Trailer to buy a 50-50 raffle ticket and learn how Mr. Charity recently helped feed over 500 needy families and distributed over 450 toys to underprivileged children. Mr. Charity Foundation. Round two scheduled for 3.
Lisa, on your unofficial scorecards as we get going again, how would you give round one to?
I would definitely give that all to Brooks.
A nice uppercut and a takedown for Will Brooks, sort of following the same method that happened in round one.
I mean, if you know anything about Alex Trujillo, the owner and the one who trains the fighters over at MTC, you know, he definitely teaches cardio. And that's what Will Brooks is showing right now. He's got a lot of energy still going into the second round, whereas Guillermo just seems like he's fading.
And again, Guillermo gives up his back, and Will Brooks is in the exact identical
position
as he was in round one. Will Brooks, he trains with some top-level fighters. Mike Lulo, who's a UFC lightweight, also trains with Ryan Williams, and now the right arm is underneath. The hooks are in. This one's going to be over soon,
that's
and yes, it is.
That's it.
Guillermo Cermet has succumbed to the rear naked choke as Ill Will Brooks improves the 2-0. And look out, lightweight division. Will Brooks is a bona fide prospect, soon to be contender. Look forward to speaking with Ill Will Brooks. And Lisa, that rear naked choke was beautiful.
Oh my God, that was just perfect form. And like I said, in the first round, it looked like he actually could have had it with Guillermo. But, you know, at this point, second round, it's a win and it's all good.
Okay.
Okay.
pumps at 45 seconds of the second round for your winner by way of tap out due to rear naked choke and still undefeated, Ill Will Brooks. Let's have a quick word with the victorious Ill Will Brooks. Will, what a performance here tonight in Chicago Cage Fighting Championship. Your thoughts on getting the win over Guillermo Sermon?
Well, first off, I just want to dedicate this fight to a woman that was really dear to me. February, she passed away. She's like a mom to me for almost 7 years of my life, and I want to dedicate this fight to her.
Well, you've shown a propensity to finish fights. You've finished almost all of your amateur fights. You've also, this is your second win, second finish. You like to finish fights. What's the secret?
No secret, just putting together a good game plan, working with a bunch of great guys over at TMTC. And eventually, I'm a product of my environment. I work with a bunch of good guys, and I just get out here and do whatever they tell me how to do.
Let's talk about the finish of the fight. If we can go ahead and bring up the replay and look up at the big screen. If you could go ahead and talk us through the rear naked choke. In the first round, it was almost there, but you did not give any position. Talk us through the replay.
I'm not really a submission type of guy, but once I got there, I just try to calm down, go back to my basic wrestling, put in the hooks, and just listen to my coaches and take my time and sink the choke.
What's next for Ill Will Brooks?
The next fight, I mean, that's all that I'm focused on right now. And the next guy they put in the cage with me, I'm going to try to finish him too.
Congratulations on the win, Will.
Thank you very much.
Ill Will Brooks victorious here at Chicago Cage Fighting Championship.
Cool.